Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Do equations like this one sometimes look tricky? Yes, they can be tricky sometimes, but it's okay. Let's do a quick review on expressions and equations.
It's like every day.
Our first expression question is this one right here. Which expression is equivalent to 4x plus 3 minus 2x? So which one of these is equivalent to this? So the first thing is then we have to solve this. So let me write it again a little bigger so that I can show you all the steps of how to actually solve this question. So to get rid of these brackets, you multiply the 5 by the 4x plus 3. So you're multiplying in. So 5 times 4, right, that's 20x, it comes with a variable, 20x, plus, right, so you're multiplying. A plus sign multiplied by a plus sign is still a plus. And then 5 times 3 is 15. No sign means plus, so this plus sign multiplied by that. But you don't have to multiply here now because this 5 only gets multiplied by what's inside. So for this here, you just tag the 2x on at the end. Now we have to get the numbers into their family. So you have a 20x here, and then you have minus 2x here. So these two go together. This 15 has no variable attached to it, so it will have to go as a separate thing. So 20 minus 2, so that's going to give us 18x, and then add the 15. There's nothing else for the 15 to be added onto or to be subtracted from, so you just tag it back on here, plus 15. So this is the answer. And what does that match? The answer is A. This second expression question comes with an actual diagram here. Which expression represents the perimeter of the figure below? So you have this figure and each side has a different variable. So you got y going around to the right, you have x's all over this side, and then coming back down you have a y, then you have the z underneath. So then basically what you're doing, you're seeing all these choices here, and perimeter means to add all the way around, right? That's what it usually means. So then when you're looking at this, how many x's do you see, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there's 5 x's. So let me just put that there. And how many y's? So there's 2 y's, okay. And how many z's? So there's just 1 z, right? So when you look at your choices here, you're able to look to see what matches these expressions on the side here. So 5x plus 2y plus z, right? Can you see it right here? The answer for this, very simple, wasn't it, is C. This next question is an equation, and I have to say at this point that expressions and equations, they're not the same thing, right? So an equation can involve multiple expressions, but an expression is not an equation. I'll explain more later on in this video. So for this question, you have v minus 10 equals minus 9. Now the objective is to get the variable v on its own, and to do that you have to get rid of this minus 10 that's with it by doing the opposite operation. So right now it's minus 10, so to get rid of it you do a plus 10, and that cancels it. And what you do on one side of the equal sign, you must do also on the other side. So you also repeat a plus 10 on this side. So now we have gotten rid of this minus 10 that was with the V. So the V is still there. So V, line up your equal sign, equals. And what's minus 9 plus 10? So on the number line, if you're on minus 9 on the number line and you plus 10, that means you have come through the zero, and V equals 1. This next equation reads minus 9 plus x equals minus 26. So just because it is the other way around, the last question, the variable was on this side, the rule is still the same. It doesn't change. What's your objective? Your objective is to get the variable on its own. So to do that, we have to get rid of the minus 9 by doing the opposite operation. So what's the opposite of this? So opposite of minus 9 will be plus 9. So now that's gone. Draw your little line here, and then what you do, you must also repeat what you do on one side of the equal sign, you must do on the other side. So plus 9 also goes here. So the x remains, and then we'll see that x equals, what is minus 26 plus 9? So if you're on the negative side of the number line and you're on minus 26, but you've only come forward going towards the right 9, then the minus 26 has gone down, but you haven't quite crossed over to the plus side yet. So then x equals, you're still on the minus side, therefore x equals minus 17. Sometimes you'll see equations and expressions together. Equations can have many expressions in there, but an expression is not an equation. An expression does have variables, and sometimes it has a combination of operations like plus and minus, like this one. On the other hand, an equation has some type of relationship. So in this case, you see a V minus 10, and then it's separated with another symbol like an equal sign, like this one here. V minus 10 equals, and then you have the minus 9 on the other side. I hope that helped. Like, comment, and subscribe with that notification bell so you'll know every time I upload, which is every Wednesday. And I will see you next time in another math video. Thank you for watching. Class dismissed.